Hi, this is Hudson Mohawke. I'm gonna talk you through one of the many sessions that was involved in a Kanye West song called Waves. Originally, this track actually had a sample and it didn't have this synth part. It originally had this, actually. At the start of it. I think it was actually throughout it, which was, let me see if I can play it a little bit. Originally had that, and I ended up sort of getting rid of that and brought in something which actually at the time I had just intended to be basically somewhere in the background, which is just these kind of simple like omnisphere choir chords. Which are just some programmed chords with some like a couple of different velocities, and then added something else which is really super simple as well, just the gross beat, which is like a kind of FL. I think it actually works in some other DAWs now as well, but just a sort of chopper VST called Gross Beat, which is comes with FL Studio. And that then became like the majority of the song, essentially, in terms of the instrumental. Has a couple of bass parts added. Which I think this guy is just circle VST. For years and years, I would like have like 10 different plugins on everything, just because I thought it was helping, and invariably. Particularly with this kind of thing, usually sort of less is more. There's probably like, you know, 6 or 7 elements in the whole song. This guy, a bass, what else is in there? There's a couple of like effect things which are very far back in the mix. Couple little vocals. Again, it's something that it's actually very simply put together, but I always find anyway that it's interesting to see how, even if things are simple, it's simple to see how these kind of songs are generally put together. There's not a whole lot happening in the whole session. Let's see, so we got a circle VST doing bass. There's some Moog that's recorded as well. This is what I get when I open a session I haven't opened for 5 years. Zebra plugin, which is no longer licensed. Omnisphere is there. Bunch of, what have I got? Like a 808 that's there. A couple of drum sounds, which are, again, kind of buried way in the background. And then just some sort of transitional kind of effect things, which again are quite buried back in the mix. But again, similar to what I kind of touched on already, it's often these ones where there's really not a great deal going on, but somehow they're still more than the sum of their actual parts. The drums are slightly, I think the programming is slightly different on the final song, But let me see how many things are here. Really like 14, 15 things, something like that. And that's including every different drum sound having its own channel. So really not a great deal of it. And that's how that was put together.